The James Webb Space Telescope has given us some of the sharpest images of the planets in our solar system, and the recent images released show incredible images of Neptune and its rings for the first time. Not only were the rings captured, but so was the planet's dust bands. No spacecraft has visited Neptune since 1989, when the NASA probe Voyager 2 flew past on its way out of the solar system. Neptune, which is four times as wide as Earth, is the most distant planet of our solar system. Voyager 2's observations whetted the appetites of astronomers who were eager to learn more about the ice giant. Now we've returned. Sort of. On Wednesday, the James Webb Space Telescope cast its powerful gold-plated eye onto this remote world. The power of this infrared machine, the largest and most advanced telescope ever sent to space, has provided some of our best views of Neptune in 30 years. I have been waiting so long for these images of Neptune, said Heidi Hamel, an interdisciplinary scientist at the Space Telescope Science Institute in Baltimore, which runs the Webb Telescope. I'm so happy that it has worked. Ground-based observatories and the Hubble Space Telescope have taken many images of Neptune in the past three decades. But the Webb's views of Neptune, taken in July, provide an unprecedented glimpse at the planet in infrared light. It took just a few minutes for the telescope to image Neptune close up, and another 20 to take a wider view, revealing not just the planet but myriad galaxies behind it stretching into the cosmos. It's aesthetically fascinating to see those distant galaxies and get a sense for how small the ice giant appears, said Klaus Pontoppidan, Webb project scientist at the Space Telescope Science Institute. Most prominent in the telescope's view are Neptune's rings, seen encircling the planet at a slight tilt given its orientation to Earth. The Webb telescope will allow astronomers to measure the reflectivity of the rings, offering an unmatched insight into this remote spectacle. New images could reveal the size and composition of these thin bands, which are probably made of ice and other debris. The ring system was absolutely mind-boggling to me, Dr. Hamel said. I have not seen it in that level of detail since the Voyager encounter in 1989. It just pops right out. Across the planet, there are bright spots believed to be clouds of methane ice, which rise high into the planet's skies and can persist for days. Nobody really knows what these things are, said Patrick Irwin, a planetary physicist at Oxford University. They seem to come and go, a bit like cirrus clouds on Earth. The Webb telescope's future observations could uncover how they form and what they are made of. Webb images also show seven of Neptune's 14 moons. The brightest is Triton, the planet's largest moon, which scientists suspect was captured by Neptune's gravity early in the solar system's history. In infrared images, Triton's frozen nitrogen surface makes it shine like a star, brighter than Neptune itself, because methane dims the planet in infrared light. NASA recently declined to send a mission to study Triton, and not much can be gleaned about it from this image. But future Webb observations should hint at the composition of Triton's surface and could show changes indicating geological activity. Triton is a geologically active world, Dr. Hamel said. When Voyager 2 flew by, it saw cryovolcanoes erupting. So there is a possibility that there are changes in the surface chemistry over time. We will be looking for that. Dr. Hamel also thinks a glimpse of Hippocampus, an eighth Neptunian moon, is pictured just above the planet. It's very faint, but it's in the right location, she said. These images of Neptune are just the latest in Webb's tour of the solar system. This week we were treated to the telescope's first glimpses of Mars, while over the summer we saw amazing views of Jupiter. Much more of our solar system will come under the observatory's roaming eye, including Saturn, Uranus, and even remote icy objects beyond Neptune, such as the dwarf planet Pluto. It illustrates that we are an all-purpose observatory, said Mark McCoffrian, a Webb telescope scientist and a senior scientific advisor at the European Space Agency. We can observe very bright things like Mars and Neptune, but also very faint things. Everybody now sees that it works. Neptune is named for the Roman god of the sea, who was identified with the Greek deity Poseidon, a son of the Titan Cronus, the Roman god Saturn, and a brother of Zeus, the Roman god Jupiter. It is the second planet to have been found by means of a telescope. Its discovery in 1846 was a remarkable combination of the application of solid Newtonian physics and a belief in a numerological scheme that later proved to be scientifically unfounded. See below Neptune's discovery. Neptune's orbit is almost perfectly circular. As a result, its distance from the Sun varies comparatively little over its nearly 164-year period of revolution. Although the dwarf planet Pluto's mean distance from the Sun is greater than Neptune's, its orbit is so eccentric, elongated, that for about 20 years of each revolution Pluto is actually nearer the Sun than is Neptune. Neptune is almost four times the size of Earth, but slightly smaller than Uranus, which makes it the smallest in diameter of the four giant, or Jovian, planets. It is more massive than Uranus, however, having a density roughly 25% higher. Like the other giant planets, Neptune consists primarily of hydrogen, helium, water, and other volatile compounds, along with rocky material, and it has no solid surface. It receives less than half as much sunlight as Uranus, but heat escaping from its interior makes Neptune slightly warmer than Uranus. The heat liberated may also be responsible for the storminess in Neptune's atmosphere, which exhibits the fastest wind seen on any planet in the solar system. Neptune has 14 moons, natural satellites, only two of which had been discovered before the Voyager 2 spacecraft flew past the planet in 1989, and a system of rings, which had been unconfirmed until Voyager's visit. As is the case for Uranus, most of what astronomers know about Neptune, including its rotation period and the existence and characteristics of its magnetic field and magnetosphere, was learned from a single spacecraft encounter. In recent years, new knowledge of the Neptunian system has come as a result of advances in Earth-based observational technology,